Now let's say we want to look at the stamp of a few elements. For example, if we want to look at the stamp of a voltage controlled voltage source, let's say we have Vm and Vn as our potentials for points M and N, and between points K and L we have this voltage source of potential difference A into Vm N connected. So if we try and write the G matrix for node K, the current that is flowing away from node K is just IV. So for IV, we'll have a coefficient of +1. And for nodal, we'll have a coefficient of -1 for IV. And now if you want to account for this IV variable, which we have, we can just write the potential difference between K and L is A into VMN. So VK minus VL is A into VM minus VM. And in this way, we can set up the stamp of this particular part. So if you try and look at the coefficients of each of these variables, it's going to be +1 for VK, -1 for VL, minus A for VM, and plus A for VN. Now, if we try and look at the stamp or the contribution of a current controlled current source. So basically in our current controlled current source, let's say a current IMN is flowing through some element that is connected between M and L. And now between K and L, we are connecting a current source of, reading A into IMN. So, to simplify our analysis in this case, what we do is between M and some other point M1, we are going to connect a 0 volt voltage source so that this IMN becomes a controlling variable. And now we can say that for VK and K and L, for node K, the current that is flowing away is AIMN. So since IMN is now a controlling variable, the coefficient of this will be +A. And for nodal, it will be -A. And for node M, the current IMN is flowing away from the node. So it'll just be +1. And for this node M1, current is flowing into it. So the IMN coefficient will just be -1. And now if you want to just write the relation for this IMN is flowing between M and M1. And these are, connected by a 0 volt voltage source. So basically we can write that Vm minus Vmn is equal to 0. So the stamp coefficient of this is 1 and -1 respectively. And this, this whole matrix is a contribution which this current controlled current source will make to the G matrix. In this lecture, we've looked at, mesh analysis and modified nodal analysis. In the upcoming lectures, we'll try and look at a few circuit theorems. Thank you.